Oh, I love this movie. It's so good.
It's okay. No Stuart Little, that's for sure.
Come on. We flipped a coin. This is my movie pick tonight.
Yeah, but, you know, let's make it known next week. Stuart Little.
All right. I don't know why you want to watch Stuart Little. It's for six-year-olds.
It's a great film, and Hugh Laurie, those eyes.
Yeah, I mean, he's a good-looking guy.
Can't beat that.
But we're not 6 years old anymore. We don't have to watch Stuart Little.
Show me Hugh Laurie.
Evil Dead is a classic.
Shut it off.
I gotta go to bed. This movie's so boring.
Come on, man. It's always the end.
Yeah. Wake me up for Stuart Little, all right?
Oh, my God.
I'll see you. I'll see you tomorrow, man.
Have a good night, dude.
You're never too little when you have a big heart.
Nick?
Yeah, what's up?
Were you just in the hallway?
No, I was,
brushing your teeth or something?
No, I was sleeping. You just woke me up right now.
I must be losing or something. I heard noises and the chairs were stacked.
What do you mean, chair? Stacked?
They were stacked up. I don't know what's going on.
You didn't
Maybe I shouldn't be watching horror movies this late at night.
Yeah, I think you just need to get some sleep.
Yeah, I'll turn in.
Sounds like a cry for attention.
So I'm on about 2 to 3 hours of sleep now for the past few nights. I keep waking up to really cold chills in the room. Furniture shaking, weird noises, I keep hearing squeaks outside. Something tells me that there is an entity inside the room here. I'm not a huge believer in this ghost stuff, but... See? I have to figure this out. It's too much right now.
Ghosts? Do I believe in ghosts? No. And I don't see why Kevin would believe in ghosts. If you're asking me, it's a big attention game. He's looking to be the center of attention. And he gets obsessive over these ridiculous things. Like that silly Great Gatsby game. Easiest game in the world, couldn't beat it. The whole drawing thing. Drawing was my thing, you know. And like ghosts, it's like that's so little kid, you know, if he was like, oh, there's a goblin at the door, I'd be like, oh my god, there's a goblin at the door? Let's go talk to him. But ghosts, I don't believe it, and I don't see why he should either.
So the apartment is completely empty. I'm here all by myself. I've decided to not go to my class today because I'm still rattled by this haunting experience. I haven't really left my room in quite a while, and I'm thinking about snooping around a little bit. I've been hearing weird activity from the bathroom down the hall here. Maybe we can see something. Are you there, ghost? See? What is that? So, I've set myself up a little fort here, moved my mattress down here, mostly because I don't like the idea of monsters and spirits underneath my bed. I'm underneath my bed, so the monsters that would have been underneath my bed aren't underneath my bed anymore. You know, I'm really starting to freak out a little bit. I recently... set a audio record of the room once when I was sleeping, and I came up with this. That's horrifying. I don't know how to deal with that. I'm freaking out here. There's something living inside my room. I recently took out this book, Weird Hauntings. It says here, if you think there's more to that banging sound in your basement than bad plumbing, you should know that membership in paranormal investigation groups is up. Fact is, whether or not you believe in ghosts, they are everywhere. It's becoming really difficult to spend any time in this room. I'm horrified! I'm freaking out a little bit. So I ordered this guy used on eBay. He just came in today. Really cute. I got it as a sort of protection from whatever poltergeists are in the room. Currently, just to let them know that I'm on their page. Maybe if they see that I'm friendly with this guy, that they'll back off, or maybe become friends with this guy. No, he's really cool. He was listed on eBay as standing Halloween character, and he's just full of life and he glows, and he's a bit ratty. I mean, he's definitely used. So he has some damage on him, but he's great. He's going to be a great asset to the room. You know, standing Halloween character. He stands really well. You put him on there.
So Kevin came home with this new clown figure today. He's supposed to protect us from evil spirits that have seemed to come to the room. But I hate him, and I hate his stupid hair, and I hate his stupid plastic legs, and his glowing eyes, and his taped up body.
I'm skimming through my ghost book, and I stumbled across this anecdote about a child's doll that came to life. Doll's name is Robert. The doll came to life and taunted the little boy. And I'm a little scared because I did recently buy the clown doll, and it seems that ghosts, entities, even demons usually take the form of inanimate objects.
I think we need to hire a paranormal investigator to inspect the room.
Inspect for what?
What do you mean for what? Ghost, spirit, haunting, poltergeist, lippards, ghoulies, Ciscos, friskies. Don't you know what paranormal means? You don't even appreciate what I'm going through in here, man. I see ghosts, I feel ghosts,
ghosts,
I hear them, I
you
do.
You see ghosts. You're just always fishing for attention.
I don't even
always.
Fish. What does that mean?
Are you kidding? Because you did it with Gatsby, okay? And you did it with Draw.
Okay.
And you did those things.
Those are things that I wanted to do. I don't want to be haunted by ghosts in
you
here.
You were a terrible
Why would I want
artist.
That?
You were a terrible artist.
That's uncalled for.
No.
Man, I made that drawing for you.
Mm-hmm.
I put it on your wall.
I
you did throw it out,
I hated
but
it.
It's fine. The point is, I need to get this figured out. I'm going a little crazy here, man.
Maybe you're just crazy.
Ah,
where
no.
is this new clown friend of yours?
Yeah, right there. He was right there.
Yeah, that's real fun. Nice job.
How could I have done that? You talk sad like a bad leaves. I gotta find some better weeds. 4 or 5 meters running around the bend when the government may just surround you again. If dying young won't change your mind, baby, 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 right here.
So I just got out of class, and I was walking out and walked past the flyer wall, and what do I stumble across? Spooky ghost flyer. A flyer advertising paranormal investigation on campus. This Dan guy is a paranormal investigator. What are the chances of that? I'm gonna call this flyer guy Dan. This is huge, an on-campus paranormal investigator. This is exactly what this room needs. It's dialing. Hey, how's it going? Is this Dan? Hi, my name is Kevin. I'm calling about a flyer I found, about paranormal investigation. I was wondering if you could come over at some point and try to see what's going on here. Really? Awesome. Thanks so much, man. This is huge for me. All right, I'll see you tonight, man.
When I got the call about going into our room and, you know, surveying for supernatural, for paranormal activity, I'm not gonna lie, I was a bit excited, but I'm also, you know, I'd be a fool if I said I knew anything about it. I know nothing about spirits, I know nothing about witches, devils, goblins, I know nothing about it. I just like to make flyers. The art of making flyers is such an underrated one, and people don't really understand, you know, their capabilities, their possibilities. Now, for me personally, I use Microsoft Word, a very simple platform, a very simple medium. You know, I do things with Microsoft Word that most people cannot do with Internet Explorer. You know, when I'm making the flyers on the Word documents, you know, my service is fraudulent. I don't intend to respond if I actually get a phone call, or I don't intend to sell the ridiculous things I claim to be selling. It's just something exhilarating. There's something exhilarating about, you know, really cracking into a Word document, you know, entering text into the word art box. You know, messing around with borders and shapes and fonts. I don't know, something struck me when I got the phone call. I'm generally curious. I figured, why not? We'll go for this one. I'll commit to it. You know, I don't want to seem like I'm pretending to be someone, but I'm going to pretend to be a ghost hunter. I'm coming in as a fan. I'm here for the ghosts.
Oh, great. Dan, right?
Yeah.
Thanks so much for coming, man.
Yes. From the spooky ghost flyer?
Yeah,
did you
man.
Like it? Did
I,
you like the flyer?
I got your information on there. I did throw out the flyer, though.
I spent 8 hours on that spooky ghost flyer. And he tells me it's in the wastebasket? No longer comfortable here. So, I got an EMT scanner, and I got a microphone to communicate with the spirit realm.
Wow.
I'm gonna do a sweep.
That's awesome. Just go wild. They're everywhere, so.
Everywhere, you say. This is a job for me, then. It's a job for me. No. No, if there is a presence here, I need you to speak coherently to me. No.
So yeah, this is my room.
This is your room.
This is where a lot of the activity has been occurring.
And this is where you sleep?
This is where I sleep, yeah. So you'll probably find a lot of entities around.
I'm getting a lot of activity?
Yeah.
So around here?
Yep.
I can use my EMT.
Yeah, see if you can pick up anything.
Let's see.
Yep.
Oh yeah!
You hearing things?
I'm hearing a lot.
Let me hear.
No. Oh, see?
I don't hear anything.
Yeah, they drifted away. They drifted away.
Get them back.
Okay, hold on 1 second.
They're usually here at this time.
No! No!
Oh, you hear them.
They're back. They're...
I don't hear anything.
Yeah, he drifted. Kevin is really buying it. It's great. Really working out in my favor. I don't hear a thing. Not a thing.
This guy... the real deal. Did you see that equipment? Awesome! I feel like I have a real rapport with this guy. He gets it, you know? Oh, I never even thought to look at the painting.
Shh. I'm trying to see if there's any life behind this painting.
It's a good idea. You gotta meet my roommate, though. He's a skeptic. Nick! This is gonna be great. You're gonna prove him wrong. Nick! Nick, this is the paranormal investigator, Dan.
Oh, great. Great to meet you. My name's Dan. I'm from the spooky ghost flyer that Kevin picked up.
He's great.
Mm-hmm. Yes, just so you know, Kevin has been walking me through the apartment. I gotta tell you, sir.
He's doing wonderful work.
Lot of activity. Yeah. And I just want to let you know, everything is being done kosher. This is my equipment. I like to fully inform my clients. This is an EMT scanner.
It says Discman. What's it? CD player says Discman. Let's see. The CD player. This guy is gonna drive me crazy. He's such an idiot.
Okay, so I'm about to tell you what you're dealing with here.
Please, I need to know.
Yeah! Definitely picking up on some paranormal activity. Strong signs.
I knew I wasn't going crazy.
And from what the equipment is reading, it's definitely, you know, you go back in the history books, you could have some sort of deity. Like a deity.
That's the worst thing.
That's the worst thing. I mean, anyone can tell you that.
What can we do right
there
now?
There are a few things we can.
We should try to summon it.
Whoa!
I have a Ouija board.
No.
We can summon it.
Put
we can
the
try to communicate
on.
With
put the
it.
On. We've been communicating. We've been communicating all along. Why would we need to summon it? I don't want to do a Ouija board. Ouija board is scary. I'm not prepared for such things. I don't know what I'm doing.
Dan, I got a Ouija board out.
Okay, I believe, from what I know, is that you ask it a question, and then the spirit does the work from there.
Are you in this room right now?
Do you want to hurt me? How is it that you died? Just said yes. What does that mean? Please spell out your name, you demon! Torbers.
Yeah, Torbers is just... that's not a name.
My demon's name is Torbolst.
Okay, Dan, that was awesome. We got so much communication with the spirit, the ghost. I think, you know, obviously this is where you're gonna lock down in the house and stay here at the haunted house alone, by yourself. To communicate further, to get more readings. We're gonna stay at our friend Bernie's tonight, but we'll be back in the morning, and thanks so much for doing this. This is such a big help.
Okay. All right, see you guys. See you in the morning. Alone, I just stay here alone. I'm not ready for this. I thought this was going to be fun. This is no longer fun. This place scares me. Oh yeah, and before he left, Kevin wrote this down on a piece of paper, gave it to me, and said that I have to say this in a mirror three times. What is this? I've scoured the internet like a drunken archaeologist trying to figure this out. I don't even think it's Latin. I'm in the bathroom and it's horrifying. Okay. I'm going to do this whole summoning thing now. Summonus, Shingbald, Hectus, Torburst. Summonus, Shingbald, Hectus, Torburst. Summonus, Shingbald, Hectus, Torburst. Oh. Deep breaths. Nothing happened. You lucky son of a bitch. This stupid... look at this stupid... This is a crock of baloney! Oh, jeez! Okay, so this is the so-called haunted room. Sort of moving out of here. I don't like the energy I'm getting. It's been about an hour in here. And, I'm sorry that I pretended, because now I'm really starting to feel it, and I shouldn't have pretended because I'm feeling really uneasy about this place. So I'm venturing into the kitchen now, which is a pigsty. I don't know if the ghost did this, or it was the people, or what have you. Look at this. A blender? Who has a blender anymore these days, right? I don't know. Maybe I'm just trying to make myself feel better. It's kind of scary and... oh, jeez. I could feel the energy. I've been hearing noises. I don't want to be here anymore. I just want to go back to my room and make some flyers.
I didn't even bring my own computer here. It has Microsoft Word 2007 on it, and that's the only version I like using. And I don't have much familiarity with 2010, or let alone Windows 7 at all. And I didn't even bring a change of clothes. I can't be here. I don't want to be here. But I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it.
I looked up a paranormal expert, a real one. He's an adjunct professor at a nearby university. We've been exchanging emails. I hope Kevin and Nick are having fun at Bernie's. I'm gonna talk to the professor now.
Daniel?
Yes, hello, Professor Grassar. How are you?
I'm quite well. How are things with the ghost situation?
Well, I'm here. I'm on lockdown in the room. Kevin and Nick went to their friend's house, and I'm locked down here for the night. And I'm getting some really bad vibes. I recently made communication with a spirit known as Torburst.
Torburst?
Yes.
You said Starburst? You should have gone on lockdown, by the way. That was like the last thing. You should have. That wasn't smart.
Can I ask you of your credentials? What are your credentials?
My credentials? Well, I'm a high school graduate. I was enrolled in an arts correspondence school. I've seen, tens of ghost films. Tens.
Professor Grassar, thank you so much for your help thus far, but I think I need to go this alone.
Alright, Godspeed. Don't die.
Paranormal expert? The most useless person I've ever dealt with in my entire life.
I'm gonna try to sleep, and I mean, I have the light on, that's good.
Just leave his clothes on the floor and leave, right?
Yeah, when I told you he was an asshole. You let him in to our house. But it's a nice tie.
Yeah, it's really
probably
nice.
I'll put that on right now, actually. It's probably look good in this.
So, ever since that night Dan went on lockdown in here, we've had zero paranormal activity. The apartment has been ghost-free. And it's been wonderful to stay here. We haven't heard from Dan since. I've called him many times to thank him after the activity stopped. But I got no response. I guess he's a very humble, modest guy. He doesn't like to be thanked for things. Very noble of him. But yeah, the apartment has been... has been safe.
So it's been a few months since Dan was here, and we were hunting around for paranormal activity. And if there's one thing I'm happy about that whole situation, it's that it shut Kevin up for the most part. And I still see him talking in his sleep about, you know, ghosts and stuff, but he's cured. But it did torch the clown. The clown is dead, and Yeah, we'll never talk about that again.
So all is well, and I feel so much better about everything. It was just... I know there was something in here, but whatever it was, it's gone now, and I can continue living my life.
Thrown like a star in my vast sleep, I opened my eyes to take a peek, to find that I was by the sea.